And as we're doing that, how about we close the circle somehow?
Would you like to give us a short feedback before you go?
No. No, we only had a little time. This is
just a moment.
So.
Just
no,
a word.
No.
In less than an hour?
I'm sorry, this was the commitment we were asked in the beginning.
No.
Just 2 words about your experience.
We don't know.
Okay.
Okay, he's getting angry. Yes. We had a little time left, so we didn't get it that it's going to last an hour. And
okay. So
we're leaving
all right.
For this reason.
Thank you very
okay.
much.
Thank you.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Can you give us some feedback before you go?
Yes.
Can you give us some feedback?
Yes, so that we didn't understand about we understood this. Also, it's very important, but we have ein verstanden, aber nicht alles.
Can you give us some feedback before you go?
No English. No Russian.
Mm-hmm. Only Finnish.
Okay, thank you. Okay. So now we would like to ask you how much you identify yourself or your self-image to your job or your image while working.
Again, please?
Yes, we would like to ask you how much you identify yourself or your self-image to your job or your image while working. Sorry? Yes.
How much do you identify ourselves in our work?
With your work, yes.
How much, like on a scale of not much to very much?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Not much, yes.
Can you explain us why?
How? Why?
Mm-hmm.
I'm an artist, so that is, I don't really see it as a job. It's what I do, and so in that sense, I identify very much as doing and being that, and those things being one and the same, I suppose. I don't know if that makes sense.
Not so much.
I look once a week at my email, and most of them is advertisements. So I like to call to speak to people. It's nice. But my emails is just information.
Please, a little bit louder.
Not much. I have jobs that I've been doing are just for making money. And I think maybe I would like a job that I could more identify with, but until now, not much.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty much okay with my job. I mean, it's first to earn money, but second, it's also an okay job for now.
But how much do you like identify yourself with this job?
I think it's leading somewhere, so for now it's not so much me, but I think not this job right now, but I'm like on the way somewhere. I'm still a student also, it's only a job, so money is more important than like, the other stuff.
I was just thinking, I wonder whether that...
Yeah.
I don't make much money.
Personally, you're also a good job if you don't have so much responsibility. You just, you know, go there to earn some money, and then you can spend the rest of your time for, I don't know, studying or making art or whatever.
So for me, it's also, I have three jobs, and I would say I identify with all of them, like, in a way, because they're
close to what I study, but still I also like them because I'm not in a very in a position with a lot of responsibility, and it gives me still a lot of freedom somehow.
Anybody else wants to say how much they identify with their job and why, how?
I can say I identify a percentage of myself with my job, which kept diminishing along my career development, and it is still diminishing right now at this moment.
What do you do?
I work in contemporary art sphere as an educator, and I get more and more disappointed with contemporary art, frankly.
And why do you think it's diminishing right now?
Well, maybe not right now, but in the several last days, because I was quite disappointed by the documentary material.
I don't have any job at the moment. I don't identify myself with any job. I cannot say how much I'm my job. Actually, I'm also an artist, but I don't have any job.
Okay.
Would
you identify as an artist? The image that you have of yourself, it would be the image of an artist?
Sorry, I don't understand.
I'm sorry. Like, when you imagine yourself, the image of yourself, is it yourself as an artist? Like, is it very connected to the image you have of yourself?
Together in your job, and if you get all aims, social aims and aims for yourself, then it might be that you can say I identify with a job. Other hand side, people say I identify with my job because I identify with well-being, because my job gives me the money to be well. So I identify with a job because it gives me money. It doesn't matter what I do. So I have different cases. Can it help you to identify with your job? And I can say for myself, and come back to the question you asked me, I'm glad to say it's not money. I do something also in social dimensions, and it helps me to realize myself and that what I can do, my ability. So I'm a lucky guy.
Maybe we should share the feedback all together. with the group, because it's not only for us, but it's for something we're doing all together. And I didn't ask from the people that left because it was obvious they had a problem with their job.
Maybe two.
Okay. Thank you. So can you share some feedback? Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think it's not long enough, actually. I think the point of like keeping people in the space together, closed, and you had to do it properly, like really properly closed, and not let people go out. If you wanted to do it like seriously, and maybe at least, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours. Because like in the first hour you wouldn't get much answers, and when people start getting really bored and like they know that they have nothing to do, then they will start talking to you, because like you will force them to talk.
Can I ask you why you are disappointed by Documenta?
I would say it's more about just the general state of art. I think I don't like that art is losing its autonomy, and I mean I understand why it's happening. Losing its autonomy, like art becomes too mixed with all these social activities and actionism and activism. And well, just personally, because it was it's not the my opinion on art like a professional, but because the first question was about this individual perception, like how do I perceive myself individually, and so individually it's not the kind of direction I'm very happy with. So it's not the kind of art that will inspire me and like will inspire me to talk about it and to. And also why I thought that it's going to be, well, I thought it could be better to close people, because this idea of closing the people in the space, it reminded me of Graciela Carnevale, probably you've researched that artist who also closed people in the gallery until they have escaped. Yes.
It's a duration of concert, and we have tried a lot of different things, also that.
Environment rather than one where people are kept against their will. Like, they might say something out of boredom, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be more interesting. I don't know.
I would disagree actually with that, because like making the space cozy, then you can hide by this coziness of the place. And when it's, I think it's quite right to be very, very cold, because like the only way to make it warmer and to make it more livable is the people to start doing something. I don't know, to warm it up by talking.
want to identify with the job? And then the other question, do you identify with the job? I think it's two questions. And maybe you can, the people can stand in the room from a level from a lot to not so much, and then split in groups, and because it's easier if you talk with five people, for example, than in front of everybody. I personally studying, and I want to identify a lot with my job when I find which is the right one, which is hard to find right now, because I'm in peace and conflict studies, and I don't know where to go. Thank you for the question.
Shall we do what she suggested? Shall we do what she suggested?
What did she suggest?
A line? And to put yourselves in a, from 0 to 100, how much you identify with your job? Can build the scale there? Would you like to go?
Yes.
Can you tell us why, or is it boring? Or?
Well, for me, first of all, it's warm inside, yeah? And I have very difficulty understanding it.
Yeah, it's very difficult to hear each other.
Yes. Also because of the
acoustics.
That's the biggest problem.
Okay, okay.
I can't understand.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Because of English?
Because of language.
Okay, okay. I'm so sorry.
It's free today.
Can you explain why you are over there?
Because the idea was like, to make the scale of how much you identify with the job, and I think, like, at least, we just talked about it shortly, we are not, we've not discussed what is a job. Yes.
And anybody else? Well, I think it's a good question because it's really the concept of the, like, for me, the job is something you do. I would say it's something you do to get money. Often it will be the same occupation as your profession. Because, like, profession is something you do professionally, not necessarily you will get money for this. Yes, but job is more about money.
The job and work?
Huh?
Job and work?
Well, I think work is not professionally. So, work is anything you do, then with a result or without a result, then a profession that you do is something that you know how you do it. Sort of, or you're an expert. And job, also, you can do anything, but you have some sort of formal institutional relationships with others who accept it, who takes it as a job.
So it is needed to have something like a structure where, by which you can describe exactly what you're doing in order to say that it's a job.
Mm. Well, I meant just like an institutional concept that I'm providing some job, some service, or some, I don't know, production, and this service or product gets into the economical system, and I get something in return for this.
Mm-hmm. Please, we can try to speak a little bit louder because our viewers don't hear us.
I have another question rising from what we're saying right now, because I am wondering if what I am doing and the other two people who were here before you came, are we three working right now? Would you say that we three are working right now?
Yes.
Can you work?
Aren't you working with us also?
Yeah. No. We're participating in your work. Mm-hmm. It doesn't
matter. The thing is that if we are all in the same line, I mean, I position myself sincerely. This is where I think I should be. And if we're doing all the same thing, but we are being paid and you're not, then what is the difference exactly?
But then I think it's necessary to separate if it is work or job. So for work, I have two works. I'm an author and a psychologist. With psychology, I earn money, but with as an author, I don't earn any money and I don't want to. So, but for a job, I only have one job. So it's, I also think it's important to separate, to use, to know. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah.
And also, I think job is more like, as you say, earning money and stuff. But work, I think we're all doing work right now, like working on thinking about where we are and like at the moment who we are and like exactly when you said. Like, how can you identify yourself as a job? I thought a really interesting question was, like, how do we know who we are also? Like, what is identity? And, like, in a certain sense, is our job not actually creating identity? Are we not becoming someone through our jobs? Because I feel like I'm still a student at the moment, but through my studies, I've become someone else too. But through what I've learned and what I've kind of lived, that I'm becoming someone. I don't really know who I am yet, because I'm still quite young and I don't know. I'm still searching for things, but I think it's through my experiences that I'm becoming someone and I'm creating an identity, if we can call it like that. I personally don't think so, because I think it's quite hard to know who we are any time in our lives, really. I don't think there's probably one way of defining who we are. But I think, yeah, we're all working right now on kind of trying to understand how we can live together and what is going on right at the moment, right now, in Christians about life. So, yeah, I think that's quite interesting too.
Can we ask something to you, for example? Because you said that you positioned yourself faithfully. Is it in relation to the work you're doing right now that you feel yourself connected with this? Like you feel that your identity is connected with this only on this 30%? Or like, and why?
Yes, I mean, I study arts, and I would identify more with the subject that I'm studying, which is culture. Mm-hmm. So here, I would not exactly set my identity as performer in social dissonance, and this is why I put myself here. It doesn't mean that I don't like it exactly, though.
I think it's also important, so if you like the job or the work and if you identify with it. So I think there's also a difference. Yeah, it's a good point.
Couldn't you call that social sculpture, for example?
Yes. But, I mean, there is a difference between the concept and trying to merge notions and the implementation,
So I wouldn't say social sculpture. I know this, everybody has heard about social sculpture. Sculpturing means to create something from another, from an existing level, to sculpt it out, and to show it. Mm-hmm. And so what you do is social plastic. It starts and you create it from mud, from social mud, you say he doesn't work. If you give him 1 euro, you create value for yourself, because you see yourself as a good guy, and so you create something. This means the beggar works for you. But what you mean is really a social plastic and not a social sculpture. You know what I mean?
I don't think that this is a social plastic, because a plastic is not dynamic. So once when it's done, then it doesn't change.
That's not true. You've done a plastic. Some plastics, there are some plastics that you can heat up, and we write generally plastic, or just set, which is set. That's not true.
But do you generally agree that we all work inside here, that we produce a value by being here all together? Do you agree with that or not?
Say it again, please.
Do we work inside here by producing value? By creating images for YouTube? Is your participation can be understood as work? Do you agree? It is work.
Also in I don't know, if you work in a factory or something, we are focused on producing one item or one thing or on a computer. It's just maybe it's that makes it work, instead of the opposite, which would be being passive, just listening. Well, I don't know.
You could also, if you read a book, you can also focus.
Work. Yeah,
it could also mean work, huh? So yeah. The term work is also
quite
flexible.
Yeah, but still, like, if you focus your thoughts by reading a book, then it's the same. But there's also a level of existence that's, or a form of existence that's maybe not focused. That's kind of in a state of meditation. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But maybe meditation also could be work.
Yeah.
For yourself.
Discipline.
But maybe work is something where you are serious at, so you have an aim or, yeah, I don't know, because when you said that work, when you're working, you are active and not passive, then I thought about kind of works where you're just at the place. So like you have to be there.
Watching
something.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a nurse who has to be on the place and not as working actually, just waiting for, yeah.
But still then you need to take care of something. I don't know, you need to make sure that the security guard needs to make sure that something is not stolen, so he needs to be awake at least.
Yeah, he's doing something, but there are also, how do you say, like when you are, for example, caretakers for children who are not at the working place, but they have to wait at home, and when something is happening, they are called, then they are not exactly at the working place, but they have to wait, and this waiting is also kind of working, but maybe it's something special, so, I don't know.
But if we are working, does anybody feel exploited now? Because if we are all working, and you paid a ticket, and we are getting paid, isn't it exploitation?
No.
Yeah, I was wondering about that, yeah. I was considering, don't I rather be walking around and, you know, what I was thinking I was going to do. So I think, what is this? But I sort of made a promise, so I'm just seeing what's happening. But and I also like to turn it around. What is work? And if you, what would you do if you were not be working? And we spend a lot of hours in a week working. And if that would not be there, would you be doing the same, or would you do something else? If there would be no, how do you call it? Obligement? Is that it?
Obligation.
No, if you don't have to work, what would you do? Now we have to work because we need to make money. So, yeah, that was my thought. And now I'm here. I kind of committed now for 1 hour. And maybe I would rather be walking around and see things. And that's sometimes what happens when I'm working.
But are you seeing something here also?
Sorry?
You are seeing something here also.
Yeah. I was okay. But it's not, you know, it wasn't really my plan, or I'm not sure if I like it. If there are other things I would like more, and then, you know, what's it like? Is it all about fun? Yeah.
I think these people are working for us right now, you three, and we pay you.
Thank you.
But you are working also by only just being here.
I chose to be here of my own free accord, and it's like I could leave of my own free will, and there's no penalty for me choosing to stay or go. So it's just you telling me that I'm working, and then you telling me that I might be being exploited, but I could choose to do nothing, so I'm clearly not working at all. And I think it's really muddying the water to keep saying we're working. I really don't think we are.
Native speaker wanted to ask more wisdom about payment also, because you get paid, and we know who you're standing here and looking at this, but we also get something out of this because we are standing here and we wanted to see this. We're getting paid otherwise. I don't know. Was it about payment? I just didn't, or I didn't know.
It was the first way we could describe work.
Yeah,
because it's like a job.
But so can you describe what you get?
Because I'm at the moment I'm a student, so I'm learning a lot, so I'm getting a lot of knowledge around here. I'm getting something to for myself. So it's about what do you see as payment, and what it does for you. So if there was no money, I still would love to be paid by some cake or nice things to eat. But at the moment I'm not depending so much on money, so everything else is also fine as long as it makes me happy. So pay me with this performance and pay me with the knowledge I'm taking with me, what I can use later to pay others with other knowledge and other ideas.
Do you feel exploiting us? Do you think we are your slaves?
I think we put you put your souls at work, and it's exactly because it's based on improvisation, and you're free to think in this environment. I think you're producing something. This is what my. But I think that the producer is also someone who uses his phone to scroll on Facebook. So in this way, I think that you're producing, so somehow you're working.
Okay, and you feel bad seeing us working and you get paid and we not?
Yes, and I would like to ask you how you could refuse to work. If this is the case, how we could refuse to work?
We're working in the sense that if we did nothing, all of us collectively did nothing, then I think it would be you guys desperately trying to get us to do something.
At least
you would be working.
See what this nothing would be look like?
We nearly had it. There were a few moments where it went awkwardly quiet about 10 minutes ago.
You know, you think it was working in my head.
But yeah, we were working quiet, but it was a very offensive, quiet second.
So my head must be shut down. Totally too long.
Without telling any word, just standing, and if we just go out without any consequences, so I wouldn't call it work. We don't have to produce something or create some value. Just being here is totally voluntary.
The question was, how would we refuse to work in this case, or by leaving? Isn't it that, if we just leave, then we would refuse to participate or to be here? So we at least would, if this would be working, this would be the way to refuse it, I would say.
Now everything is working.
So could we try hear some new voices from people that haven't spoken?
Topic, so it's complicated for me to participate. Yeah. And then also don't know how much I'm feeling. What you just said at the beginning. How feel I with my job? How
identifying yourself?
Identifying, yeah. I don't know. I don't know. I can't answer that.
Would this be an option to being confused? So confused that you can't define work, and so you can't work at the moment because you
just work because I need the money, but I can't identify. I like I drive children from A to B. And I liked it sometimes, sometimes not, but I think not that is my passion, or I don't know. But do I need to know this?
Fit more into this image that your work pushes you to be, maybe it's important.
Maybe that's my problem. I'm 30 years old and I don't know what I can do to earn money and do something that I like.
Doesn't last. The value doesn't last. What does it last? Do we show it tomorrow on the flat on the stream?
And we upload it online.
So
can you speak a little bit louder, please?
Yeah. I ask where the value takes place. We create it today, and I can see this tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody can share the value we created today with us tomorrow.
True.
Until 6 o'clock.
No, it's also online, on YouTube.
It's on.
And also you can download it, and it's at the copyright, so you can do whatever you want with the material.
Mm-hmm. So is this a fact, an often fact, to create something
you work, you create something, and it should last a little bit? Or is it also creation, if you work, and it goes away for the moment you created it? Do we need a sculpture or a picture? Or can we create a picture that doesn't exist, but the value rests in you? So the definition of work, is it work something which you have, like money? Or can work be something that is immaterial? You were speaking about a social sculpture, which means it is immaterial, isn't it? But does it take place anywhere? Expecting your brain.
It takes place on YouTube. It becomes bits and bytes. It has a materiality. Its materiality is there.
And without YouTube? Is it on us?
So maybe the camera produces the value.
Also without a camera. Here. Can value exist in material? Other hand side, we didn't work today. Without camera, without YouTube, we say we work right now here, but there's nothing, no result.
I would disagree with you because I feel like we all have something. We can, like, if we go out now, out of this room, we can say we participated in this, and it's like we could right with it. Like we could say we've done it, and it's like we have a new experience, and like we could, if it, no, that's a little bit too strong, but maybe like if it be, like we can, if it, no, it's difficult to say, but if it would be more like something where more longer and so on, we could maybe like put it on our curriculum vitae, like, you know what I mean? Like it's something we can say we've done it, and it's like now I'm very clever because I've done it. Like I think that's the value we have. So although there's no material, but we also have the material on YouTube, and that's also something we can write.
Why is it necessary for you to film this and to put it on YouTube? Why can't it just be like between us?
I don't know. I think the idea of the artist, because we are not the creators of this piece, Martinis, I think his idea was in order for people not to fetishize their experience. So there is a material dimension of this experience, so they can go back and look what exactly happened. And what exactly happened today, for me, it was nice, and I think we really tried to put our cognitive abilities all together and try to think about what happened. So in the end, my understanding of work, we did produce something. I cannot have it here, it's material, but it's also material because of the film.
I think there still is maybe a good amount of frustration in the room, good enough, but also I think that we tried to speak about a little bit more difficult terms and abstract ones that maybe it has stopped some from participating. If we produce something or if we don't, of course I think we do, and it's obvious by your participation and by your presence here, you produce with us this experience, and this could be of some value for some people that are not here in the future or in their rooms watching us right now. Maybe it will not, of course, but yeah, let's say that it could. So we are producing something, but yeah, I also understand the point that we have the obligation to be here every day, and most of you just come for once, take the experience, and without so much obligation or, I don't know, getting tired from that. So yeah, of course I understand that one is a job, and the other is, yeah, producing something, but not exactly a job to me.
I would like to say I refuse work and not make like a summary of what happened today, but I want to say something, so I will. I am wondering, like, this is more like a general thought of mine, like, being an artist, how people conceive, how people perceive the artist's job, because there have been many times when I was asked to do work for free, and people would say that you don't need money because this is something that you like. And also in a previous performance, I think someone said it in a previous performance like this. And I wonder, like, the job I do as an artist, if it is the same that I do here. As I said, I cannot exactly identify this work I'm doing here as an artistic work. Yeah, it was more like abstract thoughts.
You're wondering whether what you do here is the same as what you do as an artist. Is that how you just ended what you just said?
Yes, it does.
Can I ask another question? Do you feel, you three, do you feel exploited by the artist?
That's a good question.
You're getting paid, but no one is going to remember you.
And you're probably not
the artist is going to be part of the art history narrative one day, probably.
For me, this fame part is not so important about the question, but like, it's something that he's not here and you're filming it, so how does it make you feel? Maybe there's some feeling of, like, you also didn't, he never can really explain to you how he really feels about it, or how he's, what thoughts he exactly has about his work. So you are having, like, kind of, you're involving your own ideas about it, and it makes you, in a way, helpless, sometimes, maybe. So that's, maybe it's a feeling of exploitation also.
So even if it's, the concept was conceived by someone else, then still we're here on our free will. But it's complicated.
Like us?
Yeah.
No.
Sorry?
No, not really free will. It's not so free environment. It's the camera is one part. You have to give feedback is the other part. The thing you don't know what is. Or I didn't know what is inside here. That's three parts. They're not really free. I don't feel free.
There's a big structure.
I think the project maybe has some other ending when the people know what they're talking about. Maybe smaller groups. Maybe safer environment. Maybe that's another ending. I don't know. But that's not free.
This is just manipulation. They are manipulating how we feel here and how if we can go out or if we have to excuse for it. But you are already free. The fact is what you are doing with it. So if you can go again.